So I'm sure you've heard the stories in the news about some schools getting rid of analog clocks in their testing rooms because it's created stress by the students because they can't tell what time it is when they're doing their testing. Now, while I get why they're doing that, I still think it's really important that kids are able to tell time on an analog clock. But it's hard. I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and I hope you'll stick around as we investigate why teaching kids to tell time on an analog clock is so hard in our quest to build our math minds so that we can build the math minds of our students. Now, to start off with, I don't think that teaching time should be just something we do in a small window. It should be something we do consistently throughout the year. We should have analog clocks everywhere, have examples of when kids are going to recess, when lunch is, all of that kind of stuff. Their daily lives, we should be showing them what it looks like, having them figure it out using an analog clock. So that's where I want to start off with. But it's not something that really young kids can learn right away. We could just make them memorize and learn how to use an analog clock, but if we want to build their math minds, it's really about helping kids understand that the numbers on a clock have more than one meaning. And that's tough for our young kids to understand. So the first thing that I want to encourage you to do is make it concrete. Those kids, if we really want them to understand reading an analog clock, they've got to understand that the one doesn't just mean one. The one is kind of like a double agent. It has two meanings. The one is a one when we're talking about hours, but when we're talking about minutes, that one means something else, and that it's worth a value of five. That's really weird for young kids. So I love this idea by Regan Tunstall of Tunstall's Teaching Tidbits that helps us really help the kids see the concrete version of a clock. Isn't this amazing? Like, how fun would that be to do with your students? Having them put those cubes together and helping them realize that it's chunks of five. Make it concrete. When kids are first starting to learn to tell time, we've got to help them physically do it and see what it looks like. Okay? And I love this idea. And then as we start progressing forward, we don't want them to have to be in the concrete phase. We start moving to representations and towards the abstractness. Well, I love this one from the Frugal Fun for Boys, and now her blog is also and girls. But this one really shows using that it's got two paper plates. And so on the front plate, you've got the real like clock numbers, and then you can flip it up and you can see the minutes. So you're helping those kids see that this number also stands for something else, right? This idea is super huge to helping our kids develop their ability to read analog clocks, is the understanding that those digits on the clock have different meanings based upon if we're looking at hours versus minutes. And this is a great way to help them out. And then this one from Scampering Through Second. I love this image because it's just, number one, pretty. But I've also seen ones where the leaves at the bottom are really more exaggerated. And that hour one is way smaller than the minutes to help kids remember that the minutes hand is the bigger hand in the clock. But I also love down at the bottom where she's got the examples of, you know, what time it is when we go to recess, when we go to lunch, all of that kind of stuff, like giving it there so that kids can look at it and be reminded. because the more that they see it, the more that they are exposed to it, right? It takes more and more times before kids really internalize that. And we're working with young kids who are still trying to grapple with all of these different meanings of numbers. And then we're throwing on this idea of, okay, the one isn't worth one anymore, or even 110. Like our kids in second grade are trying to grasp the difference between one when we're talking about ones versus one when we're talking about tens or hundreds or even thousands. And now we're going to throw in one, but this one is worth five and not 10 or 100, right? They have all of these different values of what one is worth that are being thrown at them. So the more exposure and the more opportunities you can have them see that it's worth five for every amount on the clock, it will help them better internalize it. Another big thing around telling time is don't go straight for being able to tell time to the minutes. Most standards are kind of broken up with different chunks, I guess. And so take a look at your own state standards, but a lot of times we start off with just helping kids be able to tell time to the hour. So they don't have to be able to tell to the exact minute, but just at the hour spots. When are they able to tell it to the hour? Then it's to the half hour. So then we're doing half hour and hour. Then they get to where they can tell to the, like, the quarters. That's also another kind of benchmark piece, is when it's quarter after or quarter tell, which is another weird thing because we say quarter, but a lot of our kids are used to, when we hear a quarter, it's worth 25. But when it comes to time, a quarter is not 25 anymore. It's because the whole is not 100. That's another weird piece, is that when we tend to talk about a quarter, we are talking about it in relation to the whole being 100. But when it comes to time, our whole of an hour is really worth 60. So that quarter and the half is not 25 and 50. The quarter is 15 and a half is 30. So we've got to help them grapple with those ideas. Okay? And then we get to the point where kids can tell time to the minute. Okay, so start with bigger chunks. You're looking at hour, half hour, quarters, and then we move into the 5 minute chunks, and then we move into being able to tell time to the minute. All right, now let's talk about acknowledging the misconceptions. Again, I referenced one of them, which is the whole idea of it, the whole not being a 100. So many times kids think of the whole being 100. So when they're telling time, they want to think about it as flipping over to the next hour after 100 minutes, but it's really at 60, which then adjusts what our quarter and our half is, which I talked about just briefly there. The other misconception is the whole idea of knowing what hour it is when we get past the halfway point, because our clocks try to lie to us. Hey, here's a little picture that I took of my watch with Mickey lying to me. So on Mickey here, a lot of kids might know that it's 48 minutes. They'll get to where they can say, okay, I bet that that's about 48 minutes, even though the number, the minute ticks aren't really in there, so they're having to estimate a little bit. They might say it's 48 minutes. But the problem is they'll get the hour wrong. They will say 11:48 because the hour hand is closer to the 11 than it is to the 10. So this is really a stumbling block for a lot of our students. So really acknowledge that. Be sure that you are giving them analog times that reference that. If you don't have a great analog clock that the hour hand moves in proportion to your minutes, you have to pay really close attention. And like if you've got worksheets or stuff, a lot of times they won't move the hour hand to where it should be. So it'll say, it'll have the hour hand right at the 10, but the minute hand is where Mickey's minute hand is. And that's not what it looks like in real life. So you've got to make sure any manipulatives, any visuals that you are using really does acknowledge the fact that on real clocks, as you're getting closer to that next hour, the hour hand is moving proportionately closer to that next hour, and the clock will try to lie to us. So that's kind of the way I talk about it with the kids. Like, it's lying to us right now. Can we figure out the lie that the clock is telling us? Okay, so I really hope that this has given you some ideas of ways to make telling time on an analog clock more concrete, more visual, more conceptual for your students, so that we can help build their math minds when it comes to telling time. Have a great day.